Yes, people. So the next topic is related party transactions are very, very important from your exam point of view. Sir, what is related party transaction? Come, let us try to understand. Sir, related party transaction. Sir, what is related party? We'll see that the word is defined. Sir, there is something called as related party. First, we'll be trying to understand, sir, what do you mean by related party? And now, after understanding what is related party, if at all we enter into a transaction with related party, what will happen, can we enter or not, is what we'll be trying to understand. Now, sir, what is the significance of this related party transaction? Now imagine. Now, say for example, I'm a teacher. Yes, sir. Sir, assume I have a very, very good friend of mine. Or okay, forget, it is not even take about my friend and all. Assume I did my professional course. I wanted to do my brother also. I want my brother also do a professional course. So now what will I do? When I started doing this now CA final classes, I started, inviting students for my classes. Okay, sir. Sir, now assume I have started charging 1,000 rupees for you guys. And I have my brother also who is doing CA final. Sir, for him, I will give it for free of cost or I will charge him 500 rupees. Don't you think whenever I know a person, I'm related to this person, when compared to a normal student and compared to a related person, the price I charge him either will be less or it will be free of cost or as the case may be, when compared to whatever is charged to an outsider. Yes, sir, this is what is the reason the government they tried to introduce this concept into Companies Act, that is related party transaction. Whenever you are doing a transaction with your known person, we know what is related party, we'll see. The law feels you may not do a transaction at a fair price. Then whenever this happens, the law says you follow a procedure. So this, the entire concept is called as related party transaction. Any doubts here? Pakka, understood, sure, yeah? Okay, sir, now listen carefully. Sir, now to understand related party transaction, first let us try to understand who are related parties. Sir, me, my grandfather's third brother, his son, his daughter, is she a related party to me? Sir, my first cousin, is he a related party to me? Sir, now what do you mean by related party? If that is the case, people, I don't know whether you know it or not, entire India are relatives. You see, the chain will pakka go. It will connect to every person. Even a PM and CM will be a relative. You just see. Sir, so that means you can't enter into a contract with anyone. Is that the case? No. So the word related party is defined. There is a boundary. Whatever comes within are related parties. Sir, now let us see what it says. See here. The word related party is defined under section 2 subsection 76, section 2 subsection 77. The related party transaction is seen under section 188, and how to do procedure, certain limits, everything is given under rule 15 of meeting of board and its power rules 2014. So this is the entire whatever you need to know from an exam point of view. Sections, a rule, everything is important. Remember. Yeah. Okay, sir. Sir, now who is a related party? Now see here. Understand this diagram very, very. It is easy. Understand so that you can answer everything from your exam point of view. A question will pakka come from this particular thing. Yeah, it is very important. So understand. Sir, now. Who is a related party? Now people, again, our famous company, let us take our Infosys. Sir, now let us see everything from Infosys point of view. Yes, sir. Sir, now the Infosys company is trying to enter into a contract. Okay, sir. Fine, sir. Now, for Infosys, who and all are considered as related parties, what we are seeing? Perfect. Okay, sir. Try to understand. Very, very important. Sir, the first related party to the Infosys company is its directors or its KMP. Sir, directors. Sir, KMP. KMP section 2, subsection 51. Follow the entire thing. CEO, sir, whole time director, sir, CFO, sir, company secretary, sir, manager, or one person, one level below the board where he's appointed as a KMP. All those people will be considered as related party to the company. Sir, meaning what, sir? Now imagine, sir, let us take a person that is, say, Narayan Murthy, sir. Director, just imagine, today it is not there. Today I can take an example of Nandan Nilekani, sir. Sir, now just because we are going with known names, let us keep it Narayan Murthy, sir, assuming he's a director. Sir, Narayan Murthy, sir, is a director. Sir, now when Infosys wants to do any transaction with Narayan Murthy, sir, it can be anything. These two people, Infosys and Narayan Murthy, sir, these two people are considered as related parties. We are not yet seen what happened, what will happen, but these two people, related party. Okay, sir, and any other KMP, assume there is a company secretary, sir, CFO, sir, all these people will also become related parties. Clear? People, the next one. Director or KMP or even their relatives are also related parties. Sir, Narayan Murthy, sir, or KMP or these two people's relatives. Even that relative is a related party to the Infosys company. Sir, relative, first cousin, my grandfather's third brother, second son, third sister, relative, huh? To take away that confusion, even the word relative is defined under section 277. Related party is defined under section 276. The word relative is defined under section 277. Sir, who is a relative? People, aram se listen, aram se listen. Sir, assume I am there. I am there. Sir, my mother, my father. Sir, father, mother, relative. Sir, your siblings, sir, brother, sister. Assume, isn't this a family? Can there be any other person? Sir, father, mother, brother, sister. Can there be any other person? Yes, sir. Who? You will get married. So, your spouse. It can be your husband or it can be your wife. Sir, this is your family. Imagine, man. Father, mother, sir, brother, sister. Sir, if you are a girl, sir, husband. Sir, if you are a boy, sir, wife. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Now, sir, once after that, what will happen? Sir, two new people may come. Who, sir? It can be your son. Sir, it can be your daughter. Yes, sir. Sir, this is what maximum your family can be. Yes, sir. Sir, what if my son gets married? Okay, son, son's wife. Sir, daughter, sir, daughter's husband. That's all, man. That's all is your relatives. That's all, sir. The law said, okay, let us do one thing. For all these people, add stepmother, stepfather, stepbrother, sir, stepsister, stepson. I am just an interpreter of law. Don't think that I am supporting any particular gender here. Sir, stepdaughter is not there. Yes, stepdaughter is not defined by your lawmaker. I did not do anything. Shantam Papam. Yes, sir, stepdaughter is not defined by your lawmaker only. So that is the reason I have excluded that person. Sir, remember this. This is a relative definition. People, imagine everything started from father and mother. Sir, father, mother. Sir, step is also included. Stepfather, stepmother. Then you come. Yes, sir. Sir, your brother may come. Your sister may come. Yes, sir. Sir, son, daughter, son's wife. Sir, daughter's husband. Sir, everything adds step except the daughter. Stepdaughter is not included. Son, son's wife, sir, daughter, daughter's husband. Clear? Sir, Infosys. Infosys. Sir, doing a transaction with a director. Director's father, director's mother, director's sister, director's brother, director's son, director's daughter, or husband, or wife, or step. Everyone will be considered as related party. Pakka went inside. Okay, sir. Sir, apart from this, all the members of HUF, if you guys have a HUF, Hindu undivided family, all the members, even if they are, you know, my brother's son, if they, he is in a HUF, we are all in HUF, we will be still considered as relatives. All the members of HUF are considered as relatives. Pakka, now whatever you saw is defined here. Can you see here? All the members of HUF, husband and wife, and whatever we saw, father, mother, son, son's wife, daughter, see here, there is no stepdaughter. Sir, daughter, daughter's husband, sir, brother, stepbrother, sister, stepsister. Clear, all of you? Pakka? Yes, sir. Sir, now we got to know who is relative. Yes, sir. Okay. Now let us go back to our definition. Sir, director, KMP, sir, relative. Okay. Sir, firm. People, okay, I'll tell you. Sir, firm. Any partnership firm where my company's director or manager or their relative is a partner. People, whatever you see in blue are the people who are representing my company. Sir, red are outsiders. Sir, people in blue are people belonging to my company. Sir, red are outsiders. Now, what is the law trying to tell here? Sir, a firm in which a firm, assume Infosys wants to enter into a contract with a partnership firm. In that partnership firm, my director, that is Narayan Murthy sir, or any manager or their relative. Sir, Narayan Murthy sir, or a manager or Narayan Murthy sir's relative. Sir, who can that be? It can be your Sudha Murthy madam, relative only, no, wife. So, sir, now they, see what does the law say? They are a partner in that partnership firm. Sir, now these people who, my director, my manager, or my director's or manager's relative is a partner in a partnership firm. This partnership firm is only a related party to me. Sir, director, KMP, director, KMP relative. Sir, partnership firm where my company's director, manager, or these two people's relative is a partner there. The partnership firm itself is a related party. Pakka, sure, yes, sir. It is going inside. Okay. Sir, next one. Sir, private company. Infosys wants to do a transaction with a private company. Now, Infosys companies, director, manager, or relative. Sir, Narayan Murthy or manager or Sudha Murthy, relative. Sir, he is a member or director in the private company. Sir, now for example, Infosys wants to do a transaction with Arivu Pro. We are a private company. Now, sir, director, manager or relative, Narayan Murthy or Narayan Murthy sir's wife, sir, or manager. Sir, if at all they are a member, that is a shareholder or a director, anyone. If you are a member or it is. Sir, if you are a member or a director in my company, then we both will become related party. Who enforces an Arivu Pro? Sir, director, KMP, their relative, sir, partnership firm where director, manager or relative is a partner, sir, private company where director, manager, relative is a member or a director, anyone also should be satisfied. Pakka? Yes, sir. Listen carefully. Sir, now public company. Sir, Infosys wants to do a transaction with Reliance. Public company, sir, where Infosys director or manager is a director. Sir, Narayan Murthy, sir, is a director in Reliance. Plus, Narayan Murthy, sir, is a director. Plus, he should also be a shareholder. Single, that is alone or with his relatives of more than 2%. 2% is not included. More than 2% of paid up share capital. People, sir, Infosys director or manager. Sir, now Infosys wants to enter into a contract with public company. Sir, when will public company become a related party to us? If my company's director or manager is also a director here. So assume Narayan Murthy sir is also a director in Reliance company. Sir, plus, sir, private company director or member. Sir, public company director only. Who? You should directly be a director. People, director or manager is a director. Relative is not included in director. So Narayan Murthy sir should directly be related. If Sudha Murthy madam is a director, it is okay. We are directly talking here. Plus, he should also be holding shares. How much, sir? More than 2% of paid up share capital. Sir, Narayan Murthy sir is not holding. What if his wife is holding? Here, the relative word is also included. It is director himself or through his relatives. You need to add it and take. If Narayan Murthy sir holds 1%, Sudha Murthy madam holds 1.5%, and Narayan Murthy sir is a director, then this public company becomes a related company. Pakka, going, people, go in flow. Director, KMP. Sir, partnership firm. Sir, private company. Sir, public company. Everything is coming. Pakka. Sir, any body corporate. Body corporate. Sir, foreign company. Sir, Google. Sir, Google. Sir, any body corporate. Now, Infosys wants to enter into a contract with Google. Sir, who's managing director, whole time director or manager? Sir, assume Google's director. Sir, assume Sundar Pichai. Just taking an example. Sir, Sundar Pichai acts as per the instruction of the director or manager. People, Blue Infosys company. That is, I'm talking from the company where we are doing a transaction. Red outsider. Sir, the body corporate. Assume Google. Sir, assume Google's director Sundar Pichai. Sir, Sundar Pichai does whatever Narayan Murthy sir tells him to do. A body corporate whose managing director, manager or whole-time director is accustomed to act as per the instruction of my company's directors. Sir, my company director Narayan Murthy. Sir, if he tells anything, if that person is listening, sir, then this body corporate itself will become a related party to me. Don't get confused here. My company's directors are controlling their company's director. Their company becomes a related party to me. Pakka, sir, director KMP came, relative came, firm came, private company came, public company came, body corporate came. Pakka. Pause and try to repeat it. Very important. You can't afford to miss this section. Sir, next one. Sir, any person on whose advice the director or manager are accustomed to act. Sir, now, body corporate, my director is controlling Google company's directors. Sir, now, some other person is controlling my director. Sir, Infosys company's director, Narayan Murthy. Yes, sir. Sir, assume Tata controls Narayan Murthy. Sir, Tata will become a related party with whose directions my directors are accustomed to act. The difference here is any body corporate, my directors are controlling them. The next one, someone else is controlling my directors. Red outsider, blue us. Yes, sir. Next one, sir, a body corporate, that is my holding company, my subsidiary company, my associate company are related parties. Obviously, I have only invested everywhere. Sir, subsidiary of holding company where it is also a subsidiary. Sir, company XYZ Limited, it has one subsidiary called as ABC Limited. Sir, ABC Limited, now this is our company. We are trying to do related party transaction. Sir, holding company and subsidiary company, they two are relatives. Assume XYZ has one more subsidiary, that is DEF. They have one more subsidiary. If a holding company has two subsidiaries and I am this first subsidiary, that is I am trying to apply this law to this particular ABC Limited. If XYZ has any other subsidiary, even they will become a related party to me. That is what they are telling here. Try to read. Subsidiary of holding company where it is also a subsidiary. Yeah. Sir, any other investing or venturer of the company. Sir, if there is any other company which has invested in my company, venture capitalist or investing company, sir, they will also be considered as related party. People, pause it for a while, rewind it and see, very, very important. Pakka, sir, now we got to know who is a related party. We got to know who is a relative. Pakka, yes, sir. Sir, now once that is clear. Yes, sir. Sir, now once the related party is clear, one more thing. This does not apply to a private company. Exemption, remember. Yeah. Okay, sir. Sir, now once a related party definition is clear to us, yes, sir. Now see, what does the law say? See, the law doesn't say that you cannot enter into a contract with them. Okay, then the law says you can enter into a contract provided you need to make sure whatever contract you are entering into, the consent of the board of directors should be taken at the meeting of the board. People, again, 179. Sir, powers of the board which can be exercised at a duly conducted meeting, related party transaction. So, sir, one director cannot enter into a contract. If at all he needs to enter into a related party transaction, he shall make sure that that particular resolution is discussed in the duly conducted board meeting and a board resolution should be passed. Sir, board resolution is sufficient or sufficient? Sir, shareholders not required or not required as long as it is within certain limits. If that limits is exceeded, you need to take shareholders' approval. So by default, you are entering into a related party transaction. Then the board of directors, you need to call them for a meeting. The board of directors should give their approval. Sir, we need to take board of directors' approval for related party transaction. Yes. Sir, for all the related party transactions, we should take their approval? No. Only for these 7 transactions, you need to take related party transaction. I mean, board of directors approval. Only for the 7. Clear? This also I'll tell you. Yeah? Is this clear? Okay, sir. Now, listen carefully. What does the law say? See, no company shall enter into any contract or arrangement with the related party with respect to, what is that? Sir, you want to sell or buy, or you want to supply any goods or materials. It can be raw materials, you are buying some materials from them, or you are selling some materials to a related party. Then board come take approval. Sir, I am not buying or selling property, but I am giving services or I am taking services. Now, for example, I am a director or I am a private company. Sir, or say for example, I am a company, say Byju's or say An Academy. Sir, all are growing companies. Sir, we want to give certain transaction to related parties. Sir, we will give services. Tuition is a services. Sir, so services are covered. Also, the materials are covered. Two, yes, sir, buying as well as selling or availing or rendering. Yes, so you are taking or you are giving to related party. Sir, selling or buying of property. Sir, you are buying a property from, or you are buying or selling a property to a related party. Sir, it is covered here. Sir, leasing of a property. Sir, materials, goods, services, property, buying, selling, leasing is also involved, long term. Sir, related party, then you need to take board approval. Sir, appointment of any agent. Sir, all this I will not do directly. I will do it through an agent. Sir, partnership firm, I should not do a contract directly. I'll do one thing. I'll enter into a contract with an intermediary. He will enter into a contract with them. Hey, middleman is also involved. You can't do something which cannot be done directly, cannot be done indirectly also. Yes, sir. So appointment of any agent for purchase of goods, materials, services or property. See, all three are included. Clear? Okay. Sir, appointing a related party. Appointing a related party to office or place of profit in the company, in the subsidiary company, sir, associate company. Sir, I'm not doing a transaction. I will appoint my wife to the company's board. I'll appoint my brother to the company. Not only my company, my bacha company, subsidiary company, or my associate company. People, holding company is not covered here. My, say for example, me, my relatives, I can appoint them to my holding company. Absolutely fine, because it is not covered. But subsidiary, associate, my company, I cannot appoint them without taking board's approval. People, listen here, I am not telling that you cannot do a contract or a transaction with related party. Just that I am scared. You are a pakka bakwas person. You will pakka do some fraud. That is the reason I am telling you, whenever you do a transaction with a related party, make sure you take all the board of the directors approval. You do, but take their approval and do. Sir, seventh one, people, the sixth point I'll tell you. It is important, I'll tell you. Okay, let us see. Sir, such related parties appointment to any office or place of profit in the company. Sir, now what do you mean by this? See here. The expression office or place of profit means where you are appointing any person as a director in the company. Sir, my company, subsidiary, associate, I'm appointing a related party. It can be a relative or it can be a related party. Sir, director obviously needs to be an individual. So if I'm appointing my relative, father, mother, brother, sister, son, wife, daughter, husband, and step. Sir, whatever remuneration they are getting. Okay, they are getting remuneration of 5 lakh. Okay, pa, you give, I will not stop you. Sir, I am giving 5 lakh plus extra remuneration as a perquisite or as a commission or some fees, anything over and above your regular remuneration. Sir, anything over and above your regular remuneration, sir, now this is considered as the extra whatever he's getting. Now read here. The expression office or place of profit means, sir, if you are getting only this, I'm okay. Sir, if you are getting anything extra, then I'll consider this as office or a place of profit. Sir, remuneration, it's okay. It will not come under our scope. Sir, anything extra will come under our scope. Sir, this one not our scope. Sir, extra will come under our scope. Pakka. Sir, I'm not appointing him as a director. I'm appointing him as any other person, employee or some consulting person, accountant, then whatever you receive is a place of profit. Even remuneration is also a place of profit. So, sir, director, anything over and above remuneration is considered as place of profit. Sir, any person other than director, sir, whatever he receives from the company, by way of remuneration, salary, everything is considered as place of profit. Sir, why do we need to know what is place of profit? If you have appointed a person for any office or place of profit, only then related party transaction will apply. So, if you are appointing a director for a regular remuneration, obviously it doesn't fall under the scope. You need not have to take board approval. Sir, extra remuneration, then come. Call them for meeting. Sir, board approval required. Pakka, understood. This too, sir, question will come here. They will give you certain people and they will ask you whether can they be appointed as a related party. I mean, can they be appointed as a director in your company? or can they be appointed as a manager, sir, store manager or an accountant? Sir, they will give you clear, pakka, sure. Sir, the last one, underwriting the subscription of any securities or derivatives of the company. Underwriting people. Assume the company is going for an IPO. Sir, I cannot do it. I'll appoint an underwriter. Sir, if that underwriter is my related party, obviously I'll pay more commission. So I don't want that to happen. If you're appointing an underwriter, then you need to take what, sir? Board approval. People, now see, everything there is a reason, people. Without that, it won't happen. Now see why I'm telling you why this came into picture. Our great God, Vijay Mallya, see here. Kingfisher kept its board in dark on excess cash for F1 team. People, I don't know whether you know it or not. Kingfisher, sir, Vijay Mallya had one more company, Formula One. This person was totally amazed in this particular races. So what, generally where Kingfisher failed, whatever money they raised, you know, from banks or whatever, some money was being sponsored to his F1 team. Sir, that whatever he did, that F1 team, he is a director here as well as he is a director there also in the F1 team. And he is the shareholder there. Sir, see here. Kingfisher, read the line in that gray. Kingfisher did not inform its board about the sponsorship agreement despite it being a related party transaction, which is a violation of accounting standard. So board approval was not taken at all. Forget about approval. They don't even know that a part of money was going as a sponsor amount to that F1 team every year. Yes, that is what happened. It's a very interesting read up. You guys can just see this. Clear, pakka. Sir, now you're telling that we need to take board approval, correct? Sir, when you're calling board for a meeting, you need to make sure you give certain things in agenda. Rule 15. When you're calling the directors for a meeting, make sure you disclose everything. Everything, sir. Name of the related party. What is the nature? What is the duration? Sir, material terms. Have you paid any advances? Sir, how did you arrive at that price? Sir, what are the factors you have considered to enter into this contract? Sir, any other information where they can take a decision? People, if you remember, audit committee also, we had seen this. Yes, sir, related party transaction. Sir, omnibus approval. Yes, sir, same thing. Sir, if you are a related party, public company, sir, you need to disclose it. You should not participate in the meeting. You are not counted in the quorum, sir. Private company, you can disclose. And you can still continue in the meeting. Correct? Pakka? Yes? Okay. Sir, you are telling it is a related party. And you are telling you just take a board resolution. Is it sufficient, sir? Sufficient. Provided you are doing it only up to a particular limit, only board resolution is sufficient. If you exceed this limit, just like your 186 section, then people, and one more. Yes, sir. Whenever you exceed this limit, then the law says you need to take shareholders' approval. The same thing I have given here. Sir, board resolution, whatever 7 items we saw. Sir, ordinary resolution, people. Special resolution is not required. Ordinary is sufficient. Sir, when, sir? See, sale or purchase of goods or materials, by default, you need to take director's approval. If at all it exceeds, see, 10% or more. So even if you touch 10%, you need to take ordinary resolution. Sir, 10% of what? The total turnover of the company. In that, if 10% of it you are selling or buying from goods or materials from your related party, then board resolution alone is not sufficient. You need to also take ordinary resolution. Yes, people. Sir, selling or buying of property. People, property, 10% or more of your net worth. Yeah, people, remember, only this one thing alone is net worth. And there is one more thing which comes, the last one, which is underwriting commission, which is net worth. The rest of it is turnover. So, sir, 10% more of turnover. Sir, selling or buying of property, 10% or more of net worth. Sir, leasing of property, sir, 10% or more of turnover. Sir, 9.99% only board resolution sufficient. Sir, the moment you touch 10%, you need to take ordinary resolution. Sir, availing or rendering services, 10% or more of turnover. Sir, I'll not do these things directly. I'll do it by an appointing an agent. You need to take it as an agent plus whatever you do directly. Everything put together, it is not agent again 10%, directly if you do 10%, no. Everything put together, if you touch 10%, then you need to take ordinary resolution. Pakka, sure, yes sir. Sir, appointment of any office or place of profit in company, subsidiary, associate company. You need to take board resolution, pakka, yes sir. If monthly remuneration exceeds 2.5 lakh, monthly remuneration exceeding, sir, 2.5 lakh, it's okay. Sir, 2,50,000 one rupee, take your shareholders' approval by ordinary resolution. When, sir, if the monthly remuneration paid to such person exceeds 2.5 lakh, this is very, very important. They will ask you a question whether this person can be appointed here, here, here. Yeah? Okay, sir. Holding company is not included, remember that. Sir, remuneration for underwriting the securities, underwriting. Sir, the maximum I can pay is 1% or more of net worth. I mean, the maximum I can pay without ordinary resolution is less than 1%. Sir, 1% or more, I need to take ordinary resolution. Pakka, did you guys understand this? Yes. Sir, up to this only board, sir, beyond that, you need to take ordinary resolution. Pakka, yes, sir. Sir, now, you are telling that you need to take ordinary resolution. Where is it given? Sir, again 188 only. The first proviso to 188 subsection 1 says that if the limits are exceeding, you need to take ordinary resolution. Now, sir, you said if a director is interested, he cannot vote in the meeting. Sir, what if a member is interested in a resolution? Sir, what if a member is interested in a resolution? The law says section 188 subsection 1 second proviso says that if a member of the company who is a related party, he shall not vote on the resolution. Sir, just like a director, if a member is also related, sir, he will not vote on that resolution. However, there is one exception. Sir, what is that? Sir, 90% or more members in that company, all of them are either related parties or they are relatives of the promoter. Sir, the company, now say for example, Ambani's company. Sir, the shareholders are son, wife, brother, sister, daughter. Sir, everyone will disclose, everyone will not participate. Can this happen? Everyone will disclose, everyone will not participate. Can this happen? So the law says the member, even though they are related, they can still vote. When, that is, this one will not apply when 90% or more members, it is not shareholding, it is in number, the number of people, 90% or more are relatives of the promoter, they are all related to the promoter, or they are all related parties, they are all related to each other. Sir, when they are all related, then what will happen? Sir, everyone are getting benefited. So, for them, this will not apply. Pakka, sure. Sir, just like when you call them for a meeting, directors, in agenda, you have included all those things. When you are calling shareholders for a meeting to pass ordinary resolution, in the explanatory statement, section 102, whatever you give along with the notice to the shareholders, you also add the same details to them as well. Name, who is the director, how is he related, what is the relationship, what is the value, how did you arrive at this, everything, every information, disclose it to the shareholders as well. Pakka, understood, okay. People, by now you would have realized the law is telling you cannot enter into a, law is not telling you cannot enter into a contract. Law says you can enter into a contract, just that if it is, there is, you are within the limit, pass board resolution, beyond the limit, pass ordinary resolution, that's all. Sir, okay, I'll do one thing. Sir, am I Infosys? I'm entering into a contract with related party. Sir, assume I'm entering into a contract with my director only, say Narayan Murthy. Sir, what is that? Assume Infosys supplies its services, IT services, it gives it 10 lakh rupees if it is an outsider. Sir, even for Narayan Murthy, it is giving a 10 lakh rupees only. I have proper bills, I have proper bank transfer amount, everything is proper. For an outsider, at whatever price I am selling, I will sell it at the same price to my related party also, whatever it is. Always remember, if at all the company is doing anything in its ordinary course of business, whatever I give it to others, I'm giving it to you for the same price. At ordinary course of business, if you are doing at arm's length transaction, sir, I believe you would have, you remember this one arm distance in your PT period. Everyone should have one arm distance so that you will maintain a proper and equal distance. Sir, arm's length transaction means at whatever price I'm selling it to an unrelated party, if I give it to the same price to the related party, sir, 188 is totally not applicable. Provided you need to prove that it is at arm's length transaction. I repeat, sir, all this will come into picture whenever there is a difference in pricing. Sir, there is no such thing, sir. Even him, I give it at same price. Even him, I give it at same price. Then don't even follow 188, provided you need to have proper records. Someday an auditor will ask you, someday any regulatory authority will ask you need to be able to prove that you have done it at a proper at a proper price. Understood this one, all of you? Pakka, yes sir. There is one point, sir. The transaction between holding company and its wholly owned subsidiary whose accounts are consolidated and placed before shareholders of holding company. Sir, now generally what happens, now listen people. Sir, assume Infosys and Reliance. Sir, Infosys has a director. Assume Narayan Murthy, sir. He's a director as well as a shareholder even in Reliance. Now Infosys and Reliance wants to enter into a contract. Sir, for both of them, it is related party transaction. No. Sir, Infosys will take board resolution. If they are exceeding the limit, even they need to take ordinary resolution. Sir, even Reliance need to take their board resolution. If they are exceeding the limit, even they need to take ordinary resolution. Sir, imagine if at all a transaction is between, sir, a company and its wholly owned subsidiary. People in related party transaction, even holding, subsidiary, associate, everyone is covered. Sir, now the law says in the company's board meeting, if you take board resolution, if you pass a board resolution, or I'll tell you that part, you pass a board resolution in the wholly owned subsidiary, you need not pass a resolution again. Whatever you are passing here, it is sufficient. Clear? All of you? Pakka? Okay, sir. Sir, and the resolution passed by holding company is sufficient. No further resolution is required. And one more thing, that is the ordinary resolution is not required in a contract between a holding company and a wholly owned subsidiary. See here. Sir, exceptions. Sir, transaction between a holding company and its wholly owned subsidiary. Sir, whatever the transactions they are entering into, provided their accounts are consolidated and it is laid in their general meeting, there is no need for ordinary resolution by members. Don't pass the resolution at all. Board resolution is sufficient and no further resolution is also required. Why, sir? Because your accounts are as it is consolidated and it is given for the holding company's perusal. They will see it as it is. Sir, why do you need it? So, not required. Clear? Ordinary resolution, even you're exceeding the limit, it is not required. Pakka, clear, sure. Okay, sir. Sir, what if at all the people, they have not disclosed that we are related parties, then it is voidable at the option of the board or voidable at the option of shareholders. If you remember, you would have seen this even in omnibus approval audit committee. I do not disclose it. Okay, now the company, that is the board or shareholders, they have 3 months time. If they want within 3 months time, they can ratify it. If they do not ratify it within 3 months time, then that contract is voidable at the option of the company. If they want, they can put it away, or if they want, they can keep it as valid. Provided if at all any loss is suffered by the company because of this non-disclosure, such loss shall be given, indemnified by the director, whoever did not disclose it. Whatever loss the company has suffered, he shall compensate the company for all those losses suffered. Pakka, clear? Okay, sir. Sir, this entire section is not applicable to two people, ideally three. What is it? Sir, section 188, first and second proviso. First proviso, whenever the limits exceed the 10%, ordinary resolution is to be taken. I've given here. Sir, second proviso, if you are a related member, you cannot vote. Sir, these two things are not applicable to transaction between two government companies. First one, sir, a government company other than a listed company, provided such company obtains the approval of ministry or department of such central government or state government. You would have seen the same thing in section 186 also. Sir, I am a government company other than a listed company. I have taken an approval from my concerned ministry. For example, I am a government company. Sir, I have taken, for example, insurance. Sir, I take it from whatever is a concerned sector there. I take an approval from them. Sir, then I can do it without having to follow first and second proviso. It is ordinary resolution not required, even if it is exceeding 10%. Even a related party can vote, provided they have not defaulted in filing financial statements and annual returns. Sir, private company, we saw. First, section 188 itself will not apply to. 188.1 is what? 188.1 is only the seven limits. That seven limits only is not applicable to a private company. So you do whatever you want. Sir, if any company does any default, sir, penalties are 25 lakh rupees. For a listed company, any other company is liable to a penalty of 5 lakh rupees. People, your books may have a different figure. This limits are amended. Clear? Pakka? Yes, sir. So that is your related party transaction. Clear? I hope it's clear, people.